I've set up a little bit of gear to be able to work on a song by The Arrows. And so I'm going to show you. Come this way. We have here this amp that I did not know, but it's pretty amazing. It's fairly new and beautiful, has lots of different options. Probably going to use it for most things because I really love the way it sounds. Also have an old Vox, that's an old Vox, which I love. And then a 20 reverb over there. So depending on what sounds we go for, we have good choice. Fed 47, SM57, so we covered for microphones. Bunch of pedals, lots of overdrives. We won't be using the drums, but they look pretty. And then here we have a bunch of synth. A Juno 60, fantastic. An SH2, which is sounds really, really gnarly. A Moog Source, and then a little Fatty, which is great and has lots of fun features to make tones with. And here I have my Pro Tools HD Native rig with an Omni interface. So basically I have everything all in one with the laptop, inputs, mic pre's, everything I need. And I put it here so I could sit with the musicians and we could interact and make music in real time. And over there I set up a mixing session with an HDX rig and HDIO. And a bunch of stuff. I'm probably going to track vocals here too, so I have a choice of color for the preamps for the vocal. And that's about it. That's the setup.
I love these old
Do you have a session for me? A demo session or something?
I do.
Thank you. Great. Up. Let's see. And voila, shall we listen to it?
Oh, if I knew the words to say, I would say them over. I'd say them over and again, make them louder, thunder, louder, thunder, louder, thunder.
Okay, that's a great demo. How did you get those drums?
We just had our drummer play it with on an electronic drum kit.
Oh, literally record audio into it?
Yeah,
cool.
We just quickly did it like that.
Do you mind if I quantize them so we can listen to the song without worrying about the... Okay, so
go ahead.
Quickly make it quantize. I'm not going to be too tight on it, you know, say this should do. This will be easier to listen to. And then let's listen to some stuff. This riff is awesome.
Yeah.
We're definitely gonna.
It's kind of meant to not sound so much like a bass, but it.
Right. Well, I think I have ideas. Cool. And then I like this a lot. What is this? what is this?
It's a keyboard.
That's just a keyboard. Yeah. Straight in. Tweaked a bit on the keyboard. Made it as dirty as I possibly could, and that was it.
You definitely made it dirty. So everything's played in here.
Yeah.
Okay.
I'd like to discuss the structure a little bit. I just want to make sure we all agree. Cool. What's the idea behind the song?
I think we wanted to write something very repetitive, catchy, repetitive, and actually try to use as few chords as possible.
Yeah.
We have a tendency to overuse chords.
Okay. Yeah.
So we were going for a more simple structure, more repeats.
Well, it's funny because what you came up with is actually an unusual structure to me.
That makes sense.
Okay, because I mean, I expect, I hear, you know, bom, ben, up to bom, ben, up, and the whole... riff, then you have one song structure, like a verse, and then you go into a second one. Then you have, and if I only knew, and that's kind of a pre-chorus.
Yeah.
So everybody is waiting for the chorus. except you don't go there.
Yeah.
And you go to a third verse.
An extra repeat.
Yes. Mm. So you have a third verse before you hit the chorus.
Yeah.
I like it.
Yeah.
Me too.
I mean, it's a great riff. So, you know, we can leave it like this. We can always cut it up later.
Yeah, okay. We can see.
But I'd like to cut it in the current structure.
Yeah.
It's pretty cool.
Yeah, me too.
So I had a question for you here, which I'm assuming is the bridge.
Oh, if I only knew, oh, if I only knew, oh, if I only knew. You only listen oh, with your eyes, and I show you every time.
So this is like a semi-rap kind of thing.
Yeah.
Yeah, there's no drums. You just didn't feel like playing drums?
I think we just didn't get around to it.
Okay.
we knew we were coming to you, so we thought, let's just do what's important.
He's
right
got
now.
The idea yeah. now.
All right, so, okay, I have an idea for that too. Before we do anything, I'd like to import some markers in here so we know exactly the structure. Mm. So I have a template that I tend to use. Here you go, markers. Import. This usually an intro and verse, a pre-chorus, a chorus, a verse, a pre-chorus, a chorus, a bridge. So yeah. I can yeah. use the same template on everything. I just have to make sure it falls on the right bars. What does this do? Intro. Verse one. This is not the first pre. The first pre comes later because you have two verses in a row. This is the first pre. So this is a pre-chorus.
Yeah.
Which does not go into a chorus, as we said before.
Nope.
You guys are sneaky. then second pre-chorus. And then the first chorus comes here. Right here. This is tedious, but it's important. Chorus. I'm assuming the second chorus is after the first chorus. Okay, here we get into verse three. Let's see what's going on here. What's going on here? It was by summer. Ah, there's a little purgatory bar here. Lovely. So this is the second chorus. If I knew the words to say, would you? All right, then here's the bridge. Oh, if I only knew, oh, if I only knew, oh, if I only knew. Let's see, that has two parts. Something comes in here. You only listen oh, with your eyes, and I'll show you every time. I'll show you every time. That's cool. What happens after? Okay, maybe we should accent that.
Yeah.
Make something out of it. Otherwise, it's just like bridging back into the chorus. It's kind of boring. Yeah. All right, so I'll make a note of that. Or let's call it breakdown chorus here. And then last chorus here. And then the end. All right, great. So now we can always have a good idea of the song structure right here. So we can jump quickly. So I'm really intrigued by that riff. And I think, So I think it would be cool to have a more gnarlier kind of like
absolutely
angrier sound.
Yeah.
So,
And
I saw you play with that guy.
That's a good idea.
It's good.
Yeah, I like it too. All right, here, why don't we just start recording something just to see how we feel today? Great. I'm going to call it new riff. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to color it. Say green. So now we know everything that's gray is the old stuff.
Okay, cool.
And then we'll know what we can keep and what we can get rid of with the color. Why don't you drive and I'll play?
All right.
Then we can see what's going on there.
Come on over. All right. That's nice. Oscillator one. Yeah, it has a sub too.
That's cool.
Nicely,
that is epic.
Nicely out of tune. And then. So, resonance, that's the part, what's C, right?
Yeah.
That is awesome.
Nice, right?
Yeah.
Should probably tune this. So if you want to bring a tuning plugin, that'd be awesome.
Okay.
Nice. Cool, so let's see. Whoa. That's good enough for rock and roll.
That sounds amazing. That'll
yeah,
work,
right.
That's got a nice great sing to it.
Yeah, and since we're gonna have a real bass, this will give it some grit, I think. Plus, it's fun.
It's a lot of fun.
And then for the something like this at the end, right? we could do is give it a filter thing with this, so that would go. Like that?
That's right.
Awesome. Can you give me a click, please?
Yep.
And maybe mute the old bass, because it's out of tune and we're replacing it anyway. Mm-hmm. And here we go. Dig it?
Yeah.
Dig it?
Yeah.
Okay. This really makes me want to listen to bass under it.
Yeah.
See how fat I can get. Also, I want to record sample beats on the chorus and a soft synth to double the part.